Hola, ¿cómo están? In this time I want to show you how to do the installation for the sprinkler rights. This is the one that prevents well water rust stain and fertilizer automatically. Okay, este es para prevenir lo que es las manchas de óxido causadas por el agua de pozo. Cuando te mancha las paredes, este tanque es para eso. Okay, this is the tank, 36 gallons to prevent the rust stain. Okay, I want to show you how easy is the installation. Es fácil la instalación. Okay, but before I show you how to do it, this is the way this is the way that you need to know how many gallons that you need for the tank. Okay, so if you can read here, it says a different combination. Okay, that will depend on the test that you have to send to the company. You have to send a water test, and then they send you the result. With the result, you know how many gallons that you need to put it inside of the 36 gallon. Okay, let's say you are in the section 2. Okay, maybe they send you your water, it's on section number 2. So on section number 2 says, okay, here it's you need to know how many horsepower has your pump. You know, your pump maybe can be half a horsepower, or maybe one horsepower, or you know. So if the one that you have is one horsepower, so if they send you the number 2, you have to put 5 gallons, the no rust. So 5 gallons plus 31 gallon of water. Okay, 5 gallons of no rust and 30 gallons of water. Let's say again, maybe they send you, oh, your water test is the number 4. The number 4, and you have 1 horsepower, you need to put 7 gallons inside, okay? 7 gallons, let's say here is 7, plus water gotta be 29 gallons of water. You know, at the end, you will have 36 gallons here. 7, no rust, and 29 gallons of water. That will be 36 inside the tank. But let's say you don't have that much let me put you on English area. In English section, it's right here. I'm sorry, guys. Okay, English. Okay, let's say iron parts per million. Let's say you have 1. So, and then you have 1 horsepower. That would be 4 gallons. Okay, 4 gallons. Plus, gotta be 32 gallons of water. Okay, that's the easy way. So now, here is the if you want to put the Berda Grove for the fertilizers, okay? So that means you can put 2 plus 34, that will be 36, or 2, you can put, you can do the combination, let's say 6 Norros and 2 Verda Grove, and then plus 28 gallons of water. Here says, you know, the pump, you know, horsepower, 1.5 horsepower. So now you know how to do the combination. Now let me show you how to do the installation. Okay, you're gonna need the electric drill and the 716 drill bit. Let me show you the drill bit that I have. I already did, and that's easy. Okay, this is the drill that I have. Okay, I mean the drill bit. Let me see, where 716. Okay, this is 716. This is the one I use here. Okay, this is the one I use here. So you have to make sure that here is the water coming from the before go to the sprinkler. Okay, here is from the ground. Okay, this is the connection from the ground. This is all the way down, then goes up here, and then here you have to make, well, I did here the hole, but maybe I can do here, or because there's no a space, you know, the easy way to me is here. So I already did here, and okay, let me explain in Spanish, please. Wait a second. Okay, quiero decirte que para hacer la instalación se necesita. Yo utilicé el 716 de este tipo de drill bit, ok, este el que utilicé, y lo que estaba hablando acá es que esta es la tubería que viene de abajo, de la tierra. Esta no es la que va a los sprinklers, esta es la que succiona, la que va de la tierra, y yo lo podía haber hecho aquí, pero lo hice ahí. Entonces aquí abrí el hueco de 716, lo abrí, y eso es fácil porque esto es PVC. Lo abrí aquí, y después de abrir el 716 con el 716 drill bit, después lo que hice fue lo siguiente. Utilicé esta herramienta que en la caja viene esta pieza. Esta pieza viene en la caja. Déjame sacarla. Aquí está. Ok. Esta pieza, mira, ya lo trae la caja al comprarla. Yo la compré en Home Depot, la caja, y viene ya esta pieza. Después que le abrí el 716, ya queda un hueco de 716. Con esto, tú coges cualquier taladro que coja la pieza esta de arriba. O yo lo hice más fácil con una tenaza, con una pinza, con una llave ajustable, y le empecé a girar. En el hueco que hice, empecé a girarlo, y él empezó a ingresar, y esto lo que le hace es la rosca. Y entonces cuando lo ingresé por lo menos media pulgada, puede ser 3/8, pero lo hice media pulgada, ya después de eso, ya yo... viene esta pieza negra sin la manguera, y empecé a girarla hasta que ella ajustó. Pero esa pieza hay que meterla con el tape, el teflón blanco de plomero, y cuando lo ajustas bien, ahí ya después le puedes conectar la manguera. Ahora déjame hablarlo en inglés. Ok, now after you you did the hole here with the 716, you can you need to do the rotating this part, this tool. This tool came with the box, you know, with the this is like free tool that they give it to you, you know, for free. Well, not for free, you pay already, but they give it to you. So in this case, when you make the 7/16, I use a drill to hold this and start rotating. Or you can do with any pliers or whatever. They could look. You need to start rotating this tool, and then when the tool is rotating, I think about 1/2 inch inside, you have to remove it. After your removal, you have the way to do the installation for this black valve, okay? And then start put the plumber teflon here, you know, the white one like this, and then start rotating. When it's tight, leave it alone, not tight it too much, you know, just a little bit. When you feel it like it's getting hard, stop. You have to leave it alone, because something, you know, may break the part. So after you do the installation of this black bulb, you have to connect the hose, and the hose goes here, from here all the way through the tank, okay, all the way to the tank. And then I already put the Norros inside, and I fill with the 36 gallons of water, okay? So this is the easy way. Then after you the sprinkling start working, you have to make sure the valve is not open all the way, you know. If you open all the way, the water, the chemicals will be ruining a lot in your system, in your sprinkler system. So the way that you need to let it go, it's like that. Let me show you how need to go. Okay, let me turn all the sprinkler right there. Okay, you see, let me show you how need to be running. Okay, let it go. Okay, just wait a second. Now it's get the air of the sprinkler. The air is going out right now. So let it go. Just wait a second. Wait a second. Wait a second. Wait a second. Just wait a second. Let me show you. Okay, right now. Okay, you see? The water is coming down. Okay? The water is coming down. Like that. You see? The dripping water, like that. You see, the water, when dripping there, you know, the water coming here. You see, the water is coming here. You see, here, see the dripping. So this is the valve. So if you turn to the left, you open the valve. So you have to make sure that you don't open all the way. If you open all the way, you losing chemical, you know. So like I said, It's just like that. Like that is the way, you know? All right? So that's all. Para que lo tengan claro, que le conectamos la manguera aquí y allá. Y ahora que los sprinklers están encendidos, aquí podemos ver cómo es la cantidad de agua, de químico que queremos que salga del tanque. Míralo cómo sale. Mira cómo sale el... Mira, esa es la cantidad. No queremos más. Y después que viene acá, y esto lo está esparciendo en los sprinklers. Está esparciendo lo que es el fertilizante y el no rust, el anti rust, para no manchar paredes ni pisos. Ok, eso es todo. Así es que, thank you for watching. Si tienen alguna pregunta, escríbanme. Y no se les olvide suscribirse. Please subscribe. Thank you. Bye bye.